race beats people up pretty badly. It's tough, and there's no other way to put it. We don't sugarcoat anything, and I promise you that Sinister 7 will challenge every runner, no matter who they are. That's why people keep coming back. It's that relentless desire to overcome adversity and the experience, the challenge of pushing themselves farther than they thought was possible.
The reason I think this is a great, Sinister 7 is a great race for soloists is, well, look around the area. It's absolutely beautiful. The mountains, the terrain, it's a well put on race. The community's behind it. The race staff is great for helping you out while you're on the race. It's a very, very, very challenging course. So if you definitely want to feel like you've achieved something, you know, this is a great place to come.
Yeah, I like this race a lot because we choose to do the hard sport. So there shouldn't be ways to make it easier for us, and this race doesn't allow to have a pacers, so you run your own entire race, and aid station have a quite a bit of gaps between, and we're running a lot of miles on our own, which is amazing.
This year I pushed really hard from the beginning and I managed to get first place, which was very exciting for me. I didn't come close to Alyssa's record, but that's pretty inhuman, so it was pretty good.
Yeah, I came up the crest of the hill and there were these two girls in pink and their headlamps were on, and I thought, great, there must be an extra aid station. And I roll up and I'm like, are you guys the aid station? And they're like, no, there's a bear. So
we got rocks and they got their bear spray and we got our voices really low and we pretended to be really big.
We were making stories.
And we stomped and we kept going and we threw rocks and we kept running and eventually we took off.
Yeah, we kind of spread out and I think all of us kept hooting and hollering the entire way. So.
Yeah. Yeah, and now we're bear friends.
Yeah.
The feeling of Sinister 7 is a complete community. You come here and you see hundreds of your friends that you haven't seen all year and you're hugging, you know, having a beer with after the race, meals. You make so many friends and you develop so much friendship at this race. It's not necessarily a race, it's more of a community. It keeps bringing people back. I keep coming here and you keep seeing people that, you know, they came last year and the year before that and the year before that. And a lot of relay runners, they'll try to conquer leg three this year and then leg six the next year and then leg four. They want to kind of complete it all by doing everything. And then maybe one day soloing it like myself. It's just an incredible community.
Well, like physically, I've got his fuel. I meet him at each transition, and I've got his fuel, so just filling that all up, giving him what he needs. As the race goes, of course, things are going to change, so I just make sure I have everything ready for him. That's like all the physical, like tangible stuff, but you know, mentally, like I'm here for support, just show him like that we love him, we're proud of him, and that we're here for him, and like get him to just have fun and enjoy the moment. And we look forward to coming back next year.
We have a ton of local volunteers, and I think that Sinister 7 probably has the best volunteers in the world because we're working with the best people. Like these people, even though they're a bit crazy for doing what they do, because I wouldn't do it, but they are so grateful for everything. They are so grateful for the water. They're so grateful for everything that we do for them. And that's a real pleasure for volunteers to work with. So we have no problem. We have to turn away volunteers because it's just, we get so many. So that's really incredible. It's an incredible community. It's fantastic to live here every other day as well, but I really think that Sinister really highlights everything that's great about the community.
So I've been running Sinister 7. I've done it 3 times. Once as a 2-person team, and then the last 2 years I've done it as a solo. And I keep coming back because of the community around the event and it's the way it's really highly organized.
We created Sinister 7 to show people the southern Alberta Rockies in a way that we experience them. It's beautiful and rugged with boundless opportunities to explore, but it's a hard land and it demands all of your strength and perseverance. The trails are rocky, they're rooty, they're steep, and they have creeks and water crossings with bogs that will keep you on your toes. Even on a good day, the Rockies can go from gentle and warm to harsh and bitter at the snap of your fingers. If you aren't prepared, these mountains will put you in your place. Those extremes and the beauty around us forge a really deep and strong relationship with this land.
The Sinister 7 is relentless. It never stops challenging you, and that's what I think is really cool. And it allows you to be able to have everything thrown at you so that you're running some really highly technical stuff, you've hit some steep climbs and some downhills, and it throws some crazy weather at you too. In the best of times, you can be running in hot weather to suddenly you're nailed with a storm. Of course, that's all Mother Nature, who's probably the greatest sponsor of this event. But it's what it does to you there, and it throws all kinds of really great stuff at you. And of course, often people are running at nighttime, especially soloists, and they get to be challenged. They're challenged at their own questions about being able to be out at wildlife. What's out there? What's looking at you? What's following you? And not just officials and not just people cheering you on. All part of what makes trail racing really amazing. And the Sinister 7 race really does it like no other. They spend so much time focusing on being able to create a fun, challenging event for people. And that's why it keeps getting better and better every year.
Yeah, we'll see you again next year.
I'll see you again next year.
I'll see you again next year. She's my bear friend.
Going into our 10th year, it's exciting to look back at all the lives we've touched through Sinister 7. We've helped foster a sense of community, and we've made a lot of friends along the way. There are runners who came to the first Sinister 7 on a relay team as complete novice trail runners. And they've grown over time, become stronger, and pushed themselves to solo both Sinister 7 and other races. We're really proud to play a part in that so that we can give so many of these amazing people the opportunity to push themselves farther and harder.